All right, so today we are going to look at how to analyze data tables during scientific experimentation. So, as a quick review, why do we use data tables? Well, they help us to take a whole lot of information, oftentimes in the form of data or numbers, and make it clearly readable in order for us to analyze it. Okay, in a data table, remember that we always have to have our independent variable, and we will have at least one dependent variable. And when you're analyzing a data table, what is it that you're trying to do? It's just a box with numbers. You're looking for trends or the directions in which numbers are going. You're looking for this relationship between variables in order for you to be able to make a conclusion about what is actually taking place. Okay, so if you think about that when you're looking at all of these numbers in a data table, it sort of makes sense as to what it is that we're trying to do. We're looking for the trend. Which way are these numbers going? How are these numbers changing in relation to one another? So in order to do that, we're going to think back to that example that we used when we talked about independent versus dependent variables. We're going to think about this lady with all the wonderful houseplants, some of which are growing well, others of which not so well. And we're going to analyze some data within a data table to draw some conclusions as to why this is happening. So we're going to look at this very simple example. Let's say that the lady that we were discussing went ahead and set up this experimentation where she watered her plants different volumes of water each day. So some plants she gave less water, others she gave more. And then she, over time, tested the heights at which those plants grew. So you can see that she did this with three different plants with five different volumes of water. So if we look at this, we know based on understanding independent versus dependent and also knowing that in the left-hand column I always find my independent variable, we know that she manipulated the amount of water that she gave each plant. So that is my independent variable. We also know on my right-hand side that this has to be my dependent variable. Okay, this is the one that's affected by changing the independent, and so that depends on the amount of water they are given. Okay, so in this case, the height of the plant is my dependent variable. So how do we want to look at all of these numbers in a data table and step back and be able to make sense of them? So first thing you want to do is you want to look over here at your independent variable. Okay, so if you're doing the experimentation, you already know this, but you want to step back and think, what did I do to my independent variable? What is the trend that my independent variable is following? And as you can see here, you can see that it is going from very small volume of water, okay, all the way up to our largest volume of water. So that's the first thing you want to do, is you want to see what is the trend that that independent variable is doing. Then you want to come and you want to look at, well, what effect that have on the dependent variable. What is the trend, or what way are the numbers going for my dependent variable based on that change in my independent variable? So if we look here, we want to start down at the very bottom here. When she gave the plants a very, very small amount of water, what do we want to look for here? Well, we see, okay, 1.5, 1.6, 1.4. We don't know anything yet. Let's keep going. Now, as she begins to give her plants more water, so meaning as these values are increasing, let's look what's happening to the height of my plant. So if I look at my second row here, I see very clearly in all three plants, there is a trend towards a higher height. These numbers are increasing. Okay, that's some good data. Let's keep going. So you want to just keep seeing. So as these numbers are increasing, let's keep looking. We're starting to see here very clearly that the height of the plant continues to increase somewhat at a similar rate as that amount of water increases. And if you were to continue and look at every single column and see that as those plants were given a higher volume of water, you will see here a trend or a direction in which these numbers are going, that the plant is getting higher, these numbers are increasing as the amount of water increases. This is just one example, but you want to follow that same exact step, that same exact sort of strategy anytime you are trying to analyze a data table. Look at what those independent values are doing, and then analyze what the resulting change is in your dependent values. I'm going to look at one quick example here. Okay, so here, very, very simple, even a smaller data table. So you can see here, if this were to have a title, it would probably be, based on what we know, The effect of the thickness of bar on amount of mass supported. So how does the thickness of a bar affect how much mass that bar is able to support? So if we look, this is an even simpler example. Let's look at what is happening to our independent variable. So we can see a trend where that independent variable is increasing as we go down the table. So we're looking at a very thin bar all the way up to 5 times as thick. Okay, now we want to come over and we want to look at my dependent. So what can we observe about the trend of my dependent values? We can see that starting down at a very thin bar, this is only able to support 8 kilograms. We can see that as we go down further, all of these numbers are increasing. So we see a trend, an upward trend, okay? As the thickness of the bar increases, the amount of mass it is able to support also increases, okay? That is how we would look at and analyze the data in this table. And again, you want to follow that exact same process, looking at the trend of that independent, then looking at the trend of the dependent and seeing what effect this change has on these values.